What to expect from Tesla's AI Day event based on Elon Musk's latest big announcements, recruitment, robots, and really powerful supercomputers. Let's take a look at this together, friends, with the help of Andrew Hawkins from The Verge. Welcome back, dear friends. This is Armin Harayan from TorqueNews.com. If you are here first time, please subscribe to our channel for daily Tesla and electric vehicle impartial news and ring the bell so you don't miss my next coverage. And also please give us thumbs up and like this video if you find it helpful and informative. So it sits between nearly 2 years since Tesla's first Autonomy Day event, at which CEO Elon Musk made numerous lofty predictions about the future of autonomous vehicles, including his infamous claim that the company would have 1 million robotaxis on the road by the end of 2020. And now it's time for the second part. Like Andrew Hawkins says, it's time for part deux in French, which is now this year called, this time the event will be called AI Day. And according to Elon Musk, the sole goal is to persuade experts in the field of robotics and artificial intelligence to come work at Tesla. The company is known for its high rate of turnover, the latest being Jerome Guillen, a key executive who worked at Tesla for 10 years before recently stepping down. Attracting and retaining talent, especially top-tier names, has proven to be a challenge for the company. Now, the August 19th event, which is tomorrow, Thursday, is scheduled to start at 5 p.m. Pacific time, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time at Tesla's headquarters in Palo Alto, California. I mean the Tesla AI event. According to an invitation obtained by Electric, it will feature a keynote by Elon, hardware and software demos from Tesla engineers, test rides and Model S plaid, and more. Much like Battery Day, the event will be live streamed on Tesla's website, giving investors and the media, as well as the company's many fans, an up-close look at what's under development at Tesla. Elon Musk and other top officials at the company are of course expected to provide updates on the rollout of Tesla's full self-driving FSD beta version 9, which actually started reaching more customers this summer. We may also get details about Tesla's Dojo supercomputer, the training of this neural network, and the production of full self-driving computer chip. And there will also be an inside look at what's next for AI at Tesla beyond our vehicle fleet, the invitation says. The invitation that was obtained by Electric. Now, let's start with the help of The Verge with what we know and work our way toward the speculation that The Verge makes of what's to come. First, I would like to talk about the full self-driving rollout. Now, the big news out of Tesla's first Autonomy Day, if you remember 2 years ago, was the introduction of the company's first computer chip, a 260 square millimeter piece of silicon that Elon Musk described as the best chip in the world. Originally, Elon Musk had claimed that Tesla's cars wouldn't need any hardware updates, only software, on the road to full autonomy. Turns out that wasn't exactly the case. They would need this new chip, two of them actually, in order to eventually drive themselves. A lot has happened between the 2019 event and now. Last month, Tesla began shipping over-the-air software updates for full self-driving beta V9, its long-awaited, definitely not autonomous, but certainly advanced driver assist system. That means that Tesla owners who have purchased the full self-driving option, which actually now costs $10,000, would finally be able to use many of Autopilot's advanced driver assist features on local, non-highway streets, including navigate on Autopilot, auto lane change, auto park, what else? Summon and traffic light and stop control. The update doesn't make Tesla's cars fully autonomous, nor will it launch a million self-driving cars on the road as Elon Musk predicted. Tesla owners who have full self-driving still need to pay attention to the road and keep their hands on the steering wheel. Some don't, which can actually have tragic or very sad consequences. Please, if you're using the autopilot or if you're using the full self-driving, keep your hands on the road, on the wheel, and pay attention. Now, loved by fans, lauded by safety advocates, the full self-driving software has gotten Tesla in a lot of hot water recently. In recently publicized emails between Tesla and California's Department of Motor Vehicles, the company director of autopilot software made it clear that Musk's comments, including tweets, do not reflect the reality of what Tesla's vehicles can actually do. In other words, Tesla's full self-driving is not level 4 or level 5. And now autopilot is under investigation by federal regulators who want to know why Tesla with autopilot keep crashing into emergency vehicles. Friends, aside from the rollout of full self-driving beta V9, Tesla has also had to adjust to the global chip shortage. In a recent earnings call, Elon Musk said that the company's engineers had to rewrite some of their software in order to accommodate alternate computer chips. He also said that Tesla's future growth will depend on a swift resolution to the global semiconductor shortage. Tesla relies on chips to power everything from its airbags to the modules that control the vehicle's seat belts. It's not clear whether the full self-driving chip, which are produced by Samsung, are being impacted by the shortage. If yes, then this is a different question that needs to be addressed. Elon Musk and his cohort may provide some insights into that during this week's event. So tomorrow we will know more about this. Now let's take a look at Dojo. Outside the car, Tesla uses a very powerful supercomputer to train the AI software that then gets fed to its customers via over-the-air software updates. In 2019, Elon Musk teased the super powerful training computer, which he referred to as Dojo. He said, Tesla is developing a neural net training computer called Dojo to process truly vast amount of video data. He later tweeted, it's a beast. He also hinted at Dojo's computing power, claiming it was capable of an exaflop or one quintillion, which is 1018 floating point operations per second. That's a lot, that's huge. That is an incredible amount of power to match what a one exaflop computer system can do is just 1 second. Network World wrote last year, you'd have to perform one calculation every second for 31,688,765,000 years. That's why it's so powerful. I used to know why it's called Dojo, but right now I have forgotten. If any one of you guys, please let me know. A comparison, AMD chipmaker computer builder Cray are currently working with the US Department of Energy on design of the world's fastest supercomputer with 1.5 extra flops of processing power. Dubbed Frontier, AMD says the supercomputer will have as much processing power as the next 160 fastest supercomputer combined. When completed, Dojo is expected to be among the most powerful supercomputers on the planet. But rather than performing advanced calculations in areas like nuclear and climate research, Tesla's supercomputer is running a neural net for the purpose of training its AI software to power self-driving cars. Ultimately, Elon Musk said Tesla will make Dojo computer available to other companies that want to use it to train their neural networks. So this may provide Tesla other revenue source if they can sell Dojo computer to other companies. Earlier this year, Andrei Karpathy, Tesla's head of AI, gave a presentation at the 2021 conference on computer vision and pattern recognition, during which he offered more details about Dojo and its neural network. He said, "For us, computer vision is the bread and butter of what we do and what enables autopilot," Karpathy said, according to Electrek. He also said, "And for that to work really well, we need to master the data from the fleet and train massive neural nets and experiment a lot. So we invest a lot into the compute." You can see that Tesla has become computer on wheels. It's not a single vehicle that takes you from point A to point B anymore. So now, other robots at the AI Day? Earlier this month, Dennis Hong, founder of the Robotics and Mechanism Laboratory at UCLA, tweeted a photo of a computer chip that many speculate is the in-house hardware used by Tesla's Dojo. But Hong is an interesting figure, says The Verge, for other reasons too. He specializes in humanoid robots and was a participant in the DARPA Urban Challenge, which kicked off the race for self-driving cars. His team placed third on that. Asked on Twitter whether his lab was working with Tesla, Hong posted some playful emojis but otherwise declined comment. Friends, we may learn more about how Hong's work and Tesla's pursuit intersects during AI Day tomorrow, when it starts at, I believe, 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time and 8 p.m. Pacific Time. Elon Musk has been forthcoming about his desires for Tesla to become more than just a car company. He said, "I think long term, people will think of Tesla as much as an AI robotics company as we are a car company or an energy company," he said earlier this year. Now, what is the future for Tesla and for the AI? The Verge's reporter says, "A warning for anyone tuning into the AI Day livestream. Take Musk's predictions about near-term accomplishments with a massive grain of salt." You remember what he predicted 2 years ago, having 1 million robotaxis by the end of 2020, and now you know that it has not come to truth. So the things we're talking discussed during this event are unlikely to have any measurable impact on the company's business in the months to come. I'm talking about in the near term. Self-driving cars are an incredibly difficult challenge. Even companies like Waymo that are perceived to have the best autonomous vehicle technology are still struggling to get it right. Tesla is no exception. Tesla is no different. A key question for investors will be what the latest timeline is for achieving a full autonomy, Loop Fund's manager partner Gene Munster said in a note. You know, we're talking about level 5 autonomy. What is the vision for that? Here's a quote. "Despite Elon's ambitious goals of the end of this year, our best guess is that 2025 will be the first year of public availability of level 4 autonomy." Level 4 is almost level 5, almost full autonomy. "The rest of 2021 is already jam-packed for Tesla. The company needs to open factories in Texas and Germany, and it needs to tool up products for its hotly anticipated Cybertruck, which has been delayed until 2022. Full autonomy, such as it is, can wait." So let me know, friends, your thoughts. When do you think Tesla or our planet will achieve full autonomy where there is no need to touch the steering wheel, or the steering wheel will be taken away from cars, they will not have steering wheels, or that means you will not need to get a driver's license in order to go to room A, point A to point B in a car? This is Armin Haryan from TorqueNews.com with the help of The Verge. Please subscribe to our channel for daily Tesla and electric vehicle news, and ring the bell so you don't miss my next coverage. And please give us thumbs up for this video if you found it helpful and interesting. Have a great day. God bless you, everyone, and peace be with all of you. I'll see you soon in our next report.